Children, welcome to this channel. In my previous video, I have explained the domain and range of six trigonometric functions. In this video, we are going to see how to draw the graph of sine function and its inverse. Okay. Now let us see how to draw the graph of a sine function. You know that the domain of a sine function is the entire real numbers r, and its range is the closed interval -1 to +1. Okay. Now to draw the graph of the sine function, the domain values, that is the x value, what we are going to put for x, the domain values to be taken along the x axis, and the range, that is the image, should be taken along the y axis. The domain is nothing but the set of all real numbers, but as x represents the angles are represented along the x-axis. That means instead of numbers, we have to represent them in angles, but also them in radians. So, for x values, let us represent the radians along the x-axis and the corresponding y values along the y-axis. But here the range is -1 to +1. So, let us represent -1 and +1 along the y-axis and the angles along the x-axis. Right? Now, let us find out the corresponding values of y for the angle, some angles for one complete rotation. So take angle x as 0. So corresponding value sine 0 is 0. Similarly, if you take x as 30 degree, that is pi by 6, its corresponding y value sine pi by 6 is 1 by 2. And then 90, for 90, x as 90, y will be sine 90 is 1, so y will be 1. And if you take x as pi, then sine pi is 0. Then by taking x as 3 pi by 2, y will be sine 3 pi by 2 is nothing but -1. And then for 2 pi, y will be equal to 0. So having these values, let us plot this as a point and then let us draw the graph of sine function. Okay. So here I have marked the angles, the radians along the x-axis, that is 0, pi by 2, pi, 3 pi by 2, 2 pi, 5 pi by 2 and 4 pi. Right? 0 pi, 0 plus pi, 0 pi, 2 pi, 4 pi, in between the values is 0 plus pi divided by 2 is pi by 2, and the middle point is pi plus 2 pi is 3 pi by 2, that is, that will be 3 pi by 2, the middle value, like that we have to mark down. And likewise, here the negative values have been marked, and then the range is -1 and +1, okay, so only two values have been marked along the y-axis. Now plotting the values as x and y as a points. So, first one is 0, 0. So, 0, 0. And then 30 and 1 by 2 means somewhere here. So, let us leave that. And then take this pi by 2 and 1. So, for pi by 2, the value of y is 1. So, this point has been marked here. And then for pi, the value is 0. So, for pi, it will be 0. And for 3 pi by 2, the value is -1. For 3 pi by 2, it will be equal to -1. So, the point has been plotted here. And then for 2 pi, the value is 0. Again, 2 pi, it is 0. So, if you join the point, you will get a curve like this. So, this is a part of the sine graph for one complete revolution 0 to 2 pi. So, if we extend this again, you will get the graph like this. So, the graph will be extended in the same way. The same curve will get repeated throughout. And this similarly for the negative also, 0 to when it is pi by, minus pi by 2, what is sine of minus pi by 2? Sine of minus pi by 2 is minus sine pi by 2, that is equal to -1. And then you know that sine of minus pi will be 0. And what is sine of minus 3 pi by 2? Minus sine 3 pi by 2. Sine 3 pi by 2 is -1, so minus of -1 would be +1. So sine of minus 3 pi by 2 will be +1. And sine of minus 2 pi will be 0, because sine of n pi is equal to 0 for all n. And therefore, if you extend this in the negative side also, the graph will be like this. So this is a sine graph which has continuously crest and troughs. Okay. So this is the way to obtain the graph, sine graph. Now, I have said that the amplitude and the period for two concepts for a graph. So what does mean by amplitude? Amplitude is nothing but the maximum distance measured from the x-axis to its maximum or a minimum. That is the height of the curve from the measured from x-axis to its maximum or minimum. So here this distance represents the amplitude. Okay, this one represents the amplitude. And period is the distance taken along the x-axis for one complete revolution. So, for one complete revolution, what is the distance taken 0 to 2 pi, that is the length is 2 pi. So this is the period. So what is the amplitude for this sine graph? Sine graph is what is the distance? This distance is nothing but 1 unit. If even it is minus 1, the distance is 1 unit. So amplitude is 1 unit for sine x sine graph. And then the period of the sine graph is 2 pi. Already you know that period of a graph is, sine graph is 2 pi. And then here the same thing is obtained in the graph also. Okay. Now from this graph we can get some properties, that is we can analyze the function by easily by looking at the graph. So by looking at the graph we can easily say that there is no break in the graph. The graph goes continuously, therefore sine x is a continuous function. So instead of writing it using the limits, by using the graph itself we can say whether a function is continuous or not. If there is any break in the graph, then we can say that the function is not continuous. If there is no break in the graph, then we can say the function is continuous. So by looking at the graph we can see that the sine function is continuous as there is no break. Okay, then also it is an odd function. Why? Because the graph is symmetric about the origin. What do you mean by symmetric about origin? When the graph is said to be symmetric about origin, if the graph looks like upside down, okay? So that means, or in short we can say that if the graph is rotated about origin through 180 degree, it will be look like the same. So if this part is rotated about 180 degree, this will be this part. Again, this is rotated, it will be go like this, so the graph will not be changed. So that is called symmetric about origin. Okay, so a graph is said to be symmetric about an origin means it looks like the same even though if it is rotated through 180 degree. See, for example, this is the graph of y is equal to x cube. Okay. See, if you rotate it through 180 degree, again the graph will be like this. If you rotate it through 180 degree, again this part has come like this and this part will go like this. Okay. So there is no change. So such graphs are called symmetric about origin. So if the equation is given without the graph, how can you determine whether it is symmetric about origin means? If you substitute x as minus x and y as minus y, on substituting x as minus x and y as minus y, the equation should not change. So if you substitute y as minus y, it will become minus y is equal to minus x the whole cube. That is minus y is equal to minus x cube, again y is equal to x cube. So the equation remains the same. So we can say that the function is symmetric about the origin. So by the graph, if it is rotated about 180 degree, it will remain the same. Then you can say that it is symmetric about origin. If the graph is not known, from the equation you can determine whether it is symmetric about origin by substituting x as minus x and y as minus y. And if you get the same equation, then you can say that the function is symmetric about origin. And also, what is the maximum value? You know that the maximum value of sine x is plus 1 and the minimum value is minus 1. And the maximum value is plus 1 is obtained at pi by 2, 5 pi by 2 and 9 pi by 2 and so on. And in here, minus 3 pi by 2, minus 5 pi, minus 7 pi by 2, etc. And the minimum value minus 1 is obtained at 3 pi by 2. And similarly, the next one will be 7 pi by 2, here minus pi by 2 and minus 5 pi by 2. So the maximum value 1 is obtained at these values of x and the minimum value minus 1 is obtained at. So all these can be obtained easily. We can get all these properties from this looking at the graph itself. Okay. Then let us come to the inverse function. The inverse function of sine is denoted by either y is equal to sine inverse of x or arc sine x. You know that inverse function is possible only if a function is 1-1 and onto. That is, if f is a bijective function, then only f inverse is possible. Okay. Now, sine function is not 1-1 in the entire domain because after one complete rotation, that is from 0 to 2 pi, by giving different values from 0 to 2 pi, you will get this function will be 1-1. Okay. But after 2 pi, then the next for the second revolution, the same values will get repeated. That means that the sine function for it is not 1, 1. It has for all so many values, it has the same y value. So we cannot say that the sine function is 1, 1 in the entire domain. Then how can we define the inverse function for this? Because it is not a 1, 1 function. So to define an inverse function, if we restrict the domain, that is instead of r, if we restrict the domain as a closed interval 0 to 2 pi, then r 0 to 2 pi or 0 to pi like that, if we restrict a domain as a small interval, then we can define the inverse function. But even though if we take this one complete revolution 0 to 2 pi, for the first two quadrants, the sine value will differ. But after the first quadrant and the second quadrant, it will, for the angles in the second quadrant, it will be the same value get repeated. So in that case also, we cannot take the entire complete rotation, that is 0 to 2 pi, the entire interval for the restricted as a domain. So how can we get the inverse function? So the inverse function is obtained only if we restricted the domain, that is particularly if it is restricted to only from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. That is, if it is restricted to the closed interval minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2, then only we can define the sine inverse, okay, inverse function. Why I have taken particularly these two? That means the first quadrant, angles in the first quadrant as well as the angles in the fourth quadrant. That is pi by 2, 0 to pi by 2 and 0 to minus pi by 2. So that these two is minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. That means the angles in the first and the fourth. If we take the angles in the second quadrant, then you know that sine of pi minus x is equal to again sine x. So the same value gets repeated. So we have left out. Similarly, sine of this one, the angle in the third quadrant will be equal to the negative angle in the fourth. That means the negative angle, that is the angle in the fourth quadrant. Therefore, leaving the angles in the third and fourth, we have to take only angles in the first and the fourth, which will not get repeated. Therefore, what is the domain to get the sine inverse function? Minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, the closed interval minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. So now we can define the inverse sine function as sine inverse is from the closed interval minus 1 to 1, where the range is minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2, which is given by sine inverse of x is equal to y. If and only if this x is equal to sine y, where x belongs to the closed interval minus 1 comma 1 and y belongs to the closed interval minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. That is, for the sine function, the domain is minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2 and the range is minus 1 comma 1, then we can define the sine inverse as reverse. That is, if the sine function is from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, the closed interval, to the range minus 1 comma 1, given as sine y is equal to x, then where y belongs to this interval and x belongs to minus 1 comma 1, then we can define the sine inverse function as sine inverse from minus 1 comma 1 to minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, such that y is equal to sine inverse of x. Okay. So only if the sine has this domain, then only we can define the sine inverse of function like this, right? So inverse function does not exist for any other closed interval with a zero, including zero. Any other a larger closed interval with a zero, including zero, okay? Only this interval minus pi by 2 plus pi by 2, okay, for this interval only we can define the sine inverse function. Also, we can have the restricted domains for sine function as instead of minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, if we restrict the domain as pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2 or 3 pi by 2 to 5 pi by 2, etc., minus pi by 2 to minus 3 pi by 2, we can also define the inverse sine function, okay? But among this, the smallest one is minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So that domain is called the principal domain of sine function, and the corresponding values of the y is called principal values of inverse sine function. So okay, so many domains can be restricted domains can be used. That is minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2, pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2, 3 pi by 2 to 5 pi by 2, etc. Among this, the smallest one, minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2, is called the principal domain of the sine function, and the corresponding values are called the principal values of the inverse sine function when we use the principal domain. Okay. Now let us see some results. Oh, the first one is the definition. That is nothing but the definition. That is, y is equal to sine inverse x is possible only if sine y is equal to x. Okay, if and only if condition is, if and only if sine x is equal to y. What would be the value of x? X ranges from minus 1 to plus 1, and y ranges from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Okay, that is nothing but the definition of inverse, right? Then sine of sine inverse of x. What is sine of sine inverse of x? Sine inverse of x is nothing but y. So sine y. What is sine y? Sine y is equal to x. So sine of sine inverse of x is equal to x, right? That means these are, as they are reverse function, they will be, that is, sine of sine inverse of x is equal to x because they are inverse to each other. Now, particularly, this is possible only if modulus of x is less than or equal to 1. What is nothing, this is nothing but minus 1 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 1. So this is written as, rewritten as modulus of x is less than or equal to 1. And no sense if modulus of x is greater than 1 means x shouldn't take the value above 1 and below minus 1. That's why they have given like this, modulus of x is greater than 1. So sine of sine inverse of x is equal to x, right? Similarly, what is sine inverse of sine y? That is, if a sine inverse function is outside and inside function is sine y, then what would be its value? Sine inverse of, what is sine y? Sine y is equal to x. Sine inverse of x is nothing but y. Therefore, sine inverse of sine y is equal to y. Whether sine inverse lies outside or inside, the value will be the same. That is, sine inverse of sine y is equal to y. Again, y should lies between minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. Right? So, the replacing x, y by x, that is, instead of using another variable, let us represent this by a single variable x. I have replaced y by x. So what is sine inverse of sine x? Sine inverse of sine x is equal to x, where x lies between minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. Just I have replaced y by x in order to tell that using the same variable, I have expressed, replaced y by x, right? Now, using this here, sine inverse of sine 2 pi means immediately you shouldn't write that it is equal to 2 pi, because this 2 pi doesn't lies in between minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2, right? So what is the result for a sine inverse of sine 2 pi? That is equal to 0, as 0 belongs to the interval minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. So you shouldn't write that sine inverse of sine 2 pi is equal to 2 pi. Sine 2 pi value is 0, therefore sine inverse of this one is 0. As 0 is the only angle between, lies between the given interval, right? Now, if x lies in the next domain, restricted domain pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2, then what would be the value of sine inverse of sine x, etc.? So, rewriting this to, in this form, minus pi by 2 to less than or equal to x less than or equal to pi by 2, using this, right? Rewriting in this way, what you have to do, let us multiply throughout by 1 minus. When you multiply 1 minus, this inequality will get reversed, right? And then add pi to get to all. So pi minus pi by 2 is greater than or equal to pi minus x is greater than or equal to pi minus 3 pi by 2. So on simplifying, this will be pi by 2 greater than or equal to pi minus x is greater than or equal to minus pi by 2. That is, minus pi by 2 is less than or equal to pi minus x is less than or equal to pi by 2. So if x belongs to the another restricted domain pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2, after converting this to in the restricted domain, minor principal domain, minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2, the x will take the value pi minus x. So sine inverse of sine x will be equal to pi minus x if x belongs to the another restricted domain pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2. Okay. Then sine inverse of x is also an odd function. Now let us see how the graph of the sine inverse, that is inverse sine function. So x and y is equal to sin inverse. Let us plot the points. The maximum value is one and the minimum value is -1. So let us write down the values for that and one value in between 0. The corresponding value of y is, that is the angle is, for x is equal to -1, the corresponding angle y is -π/2. For x is equal to 0, the corresponding angle is 0. And for x is equal to 1, the corresponding y value is π/2, because sine π/2 is 1 and sine of -π/2 is -1 and sine 0 is 0. The definition is itself. Y is equal to sine inverse of x means x will be equal to sine y. So from that we have obtained these values. By plotting the points, we get the sine graph like this. Okay, this is the sine graph, right? So taking 1 and -1 along x-axis and -π/2 to π/2 along y-axis. So this is the graph, sine graph. So this is the sine graph for this restricted, if we restrict the domain for sine function as -π/2 to π/2. Now what are the properties of the inverse sine function? It passes through the origin. Again, as like the sine graph, sine inverse graph also passes through the origin. And you can see that just this is the reflection of the portion. Sine graph is a continuous graph. So this is a part of the sine graph, that is part of the sine graph which is reflected about the line y is equal to x, right? And also this graph is also symmetric about origin, as that because if you rotate through 180 degree, you will get the same. So this is also symmetric about origin. That means that this is an odd function, right? Now look at this. This line is y is equal to x, that is at 45 degree. The line drawn is called y is equal to x. Along this line, all the points, the x coordinate and y coordinate will be same. And then here the red 1π/2, -1π/2 and the red curve represent the sine graph. Okay, y is equal to sine x. And for the values, the red graph represent the inverse function, and for the green one, the -π/2, -1 to π/1, this one represents the sine graph. So they're about the line y is equal to x, they are just reflected. Okay, so we can see that sine graph is, sine inverse is the reflection of the sine graph about the line y is equal to x in between the principal domain -π/2 to π/2. Then also, if the function is represented as y is equal to a sin bx plus c or y is equal to a cos bx plus c, if the function is in this form, then such functions are called sinusoidal functions. Okay, sinusoidal functions. For that sinusoidal functions, the amplitude and the period is obtained by the formula amplitude is equal to modulus of a and the period is equal to 2π/modulus of b. So if the functions in this form as a into sine of bx plus c or a into cos of bx plus c, such sinusoidal functions, for that called as sinusoidal functions, and for such sinusoidal functions amplitude is given by modulus of a and the period is given by 2π/modulus of b. And also if your function f is the summation of two functions g and h, then the period of f is nothing but LCM of the period of g and h. Okay, and then the graph of the sinusoidal functions is also obtained by extending the portion of the graph on the interval 0 to this 2π/modulus of b. So if we draw the graph between the closed interval 0 to 2π/modulus of b, and we can extend the same part to get the entire graph of the sinusoidal functions.